At Verma, chapter 6, question number 23. Find the acceleration A1, A2, A3 of the three blocks shown. If a horizontal force of 10 N is applied on A, 2 kg block, B, 3 kg block, C, 7 kg block. For proper understanding of the basic framework used in such questions, you might like to watch our solution to question number 22 of the same chapter. Link for the video is shown on the screen and given in the descriptions below. If we assume that all the three blocks move together, then they can be taken as a single system of mass m1 plus m2 plus m3. The only external force in horizontal direction acting on this system is F. Therefore, if all the blocks move together, their common acceleration will be F divided by m1 plus m2 plus m3 or 10 by 12 meter per second square. If we take m2 and m3 as single system, then mass of the system is 10 kg and the only horizontal force acting on the system is friction between m1 and m2. The maximum possible magnitude of this friction is mu1 m1g or 0.2 into 2 into 10, that is 4 newtons. The mass of the system is 10 kg. Therefore, the maximum possible acceleration of the system comprising m2 and m3 is equal to 4 by 10 or 0.4 meters per second square. Thus, the maximum possible acceleration of M2-M3 system is less than the acceleration of all the blocks if they move together. This implies all the blocks cannot move together. If M1 and M2 are not moving together, then there is a relative slipping between the two blocks and hence the magnitude of the friction is mu into M1 into G, that is 4 newtons. On M1, the horizontal forces acting are 10 newton force in forward direction and 4 newton friction in backward direction. Therefore, the net horizontal force on the block is 10 minus 4 or 6 newtons. Mass of the block is 2 kg. Therefore, its acceleration is 3 meter per second square. The only horizontal force acting on M3 is friction between M2 and M3. The normal at this contact is equal to weight of M1 and M2 combined. Hence, the magnitude of normal at this surface is M1 plus M2g. Therefore, the maximum possible horizontal force on M3 is mu2 into M1 plus M2 into g. That is 0.5 into 5 into 10 or 15 newtons. Thus, the maximum possible acceleration of M3 is 15 by 7 meter per second square. Since the maximum possible acceleration of M3 is more than the acceleration of M2-M3 system, both the blocks move together with acceleration 0.4 meter per second square. Thus, if 10 newton force is applied to the uppermost block moves with acceleration 3 meter per second square, and the bottom two blocks move with acceleration 0.4 meter per second square. This is answer to part A of the question. In part B, the force is being applied on the middle block. If all the masses move together, then as we calculated in last part, their common acceleration will be 10 by 12 meter per second square. In this case, the only horizontal force acting on the topmost block is friction. We have calculated in last part the maximum value of friction is 4 newtons. Since the mass of the block is 2 kg, its maximum possible acceleration is 2 meter per second square. Also, we have calculated in last part the maximum possible acceleration of 7 kg block if it is moved only by friction is 15 by 7 meter per second square. Since the maximum possible acceleration of the topmost and the bottommost block is more than the acceleration of the combined system, all the blocks in this case move together and their common acceleration is 10 by 12 meter per second square, that is 5 by 6 meter per second square. This is answer to part B of the question. In part C of the question, the force is being applied to the bottommost block. If all the blocks move together, then their common acceleration is 10 by 12 or 5 by 6 meter per second square. If we take M1 and M2 as system, the only horizontal force acting on this system is friction between the blocks. The maximum value of this friction is mu2 into M1 plus M2 into G, that is 15 newtons. Since the mass of the system is 5 kg, the maximum possible acceleration of this system is 15 divided by 5, that is 3 meter per second square. Also, in the last part, we have calculated the maximum possible acceleration of the topmost block to be 2 meter per second square. Since all these values are more than the common acceleration of the combined system, all the blocks move together and their acceleration is 5 by 6 meter per second square. This is answer to part C of the question. In order to request solution to any question from H.C. Verma book, post the question number and chapter number in comments below. Like and share the video to help other students find us. Subscribe the channel, like our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter for latest updates. Thank you for watching.